In the capital of Indonesia's remote Papua province, government offices set alight by protesters 24 hours earlier are still burning. Thursday's demonstrations were triggered by videos circulated online showing Indonesian security forces calling Papuan students monkeys and dogs. Protest leaders say the government must treat Papuans equally.
Why is law enforcement not conducted properly, especially in Surabaya? The legal process started after we demonstrated, but racism has happened a long time, fueling Papuans' anger.
In 1963, the UN declared Indonesia could take control of West Papua if its inhabitants agreed in a referendum. But when the election took place 6 years later, only around 1,000 people took part. They voted in favour of Indonesia, but many Papuans say the vote was rigged. Grievances over discrimination have been further inflamed by concerns that Papuans haven't benefited from the wealth generated by the region's minerals. The government says it's investigating the allegations of rights abuses by security forces and it's called for calm.
Let's ask ourselves, why must we kill each other because we're offended by something and we've already dealt with the case through the law?
The government cut internet access to the province last week in an attempt to curb the protests. If anything, that strategy appears to have backfired. Victoria Gatenby, Al Jazeera.